I saw a bumper sticker the other day that said, my kids have fur and paws. And I was like, come on, they can't be that ugly. I don't have kids. I can barely afford my own drugs. I don't know. Kid, people get, a lot of my friends are starting to have babies now, which is rude, you know, because they didn't ask me. And people start having babies that cancel plans all the time. I hate my friends' babies. I hate them. And you can't tell your friends you hate their baby. You know what I mean? Because they don't have a personality. You don't have a reason to hate this baby. I can't tell them they owe me money or I saw them kick a dog. People go baby crazy. You ever seen that show 19 and Counting? Holy shit. 19 and Counting? And Counting? Pull out. I did the math on that with my fiance. We did the math on it. If she's had 19 children, that means she spent 14 years of her life pregnant. Correct. Yeah, my fiance looked at me. She's like, I can't even imagine being pregnant for 9 months. And I looked right back at her and said, I can't imagine you being pregnant for the drive to the abortion clinic. My friend's kids, they ruin our plans before they're even born. A couple years ago, I was doing shows at Planet Hollywood on the Strip, Super Bowl weekend. I invited my friend Sean and his wife Laura out. I was like, you guys should come out Super Bowl weekend. It's going to be awesome. See some comedy. We'll make some bets. We'll watch a game in the sports book. Sweet. Because Sean and his wife Laura love Las Vegas. They come all the time. But this time they said no. Said, we can't come because Laura, his wife, 4 months pregnant. And it probably wouldn't be a good idea to come to Vegas and be in a smoky casino for 3 days. Because if anything happened and the baby came out fucked up, her words, we would always blame ourselves and wonder, was it that weekend in Vegas that fucked up our baby? And I was like, good point, you know. But if you don't come, then it's just genetic. You know? The baby comes fucked up. You don't have an excuse, you know? It's hard to look at a fucked up baby and be like, we did everything right. The baby's fine. Well, it's not fine, but it's healthy. It's, they named the baby Xander, Wakanda forever. And Xander with an X, and I was like, what's the goal here? You know, you want him to grow up to be a clown or a magician? And they're like, Patrick, you don't understand. We named him Xander. He's X. That's going to help him get a lot of pussy in life. And I was like, first of all, I think you're cock blocking this kid more than you know. It's like, Patrick, you don't understand. There are a lot of women out there in the world who have made it their goal to try to fuck their way through the alphabet. He is X. That's a hard, hard letter to cross off the list. And I said a couple of things. Number one, I'm not sure it's appropriate for you to name your only son after the 7 psychopath women in the world who are trying to fuck their way through the alphabet. Number two, he better wear 2 condoms because X comes at the end of the alphabet. And he is definitely going to get chlamydia from some girl in university who just fucked her way through all the LMNOs. You know what I mean? Facts.